there special problems for you. But this morning, there is a special person with you. Hallelujah. There is a special person with you. Repeatedly, the Bible tells us that God was ever with Joseph. In everything Joseph faced, he had a helper and he had a companion. Three times in chapter 39, we are told that the Lord was with Joseph. It would be helpful for us to see just how the Lord was with him. He was with him in servitude. Even though Joseph was a slave, listen to me carefully. Even though Joseph was a slave, he conducted himself as a ruler. Yeah. Hallelujah. What does this tell you as a child of God? Even though you face a mountain today, you ought to walk with your head up high. Hallelujah. And say, if God be for me, no one can be against me. I am a success. Hallelujah. I am blessed. I am an overcomer. That's what you ought to say. Joseph conducted himself as a ruler. Joseph wasn't complaining. He wasn't whining. He wasn't bellyaching. Neither was forcing. Joseph just served Potiphar, and he did it well. Even while in prison, Joseph was a good prisoner. He served well. You know, sometimes when we face storms, we use it as an opportunity to not be in the house of God. A lot of times people face storm, and instead of coming to cry out and seek help in the house of God, they take three steps back, and you miss them for months. You won't see them. But this morning, I want to encourage you, like Joseph, serve, hallelujah. Even though you're facing a storm, come and serve God, hallelujah. Find yourself in some type of ministry and serve God. I might be facing that storm, Father, but I will serve you, hallelujah. I might be in the valley, but I will serve. I will come, and whatever is there to do in the house of God, I'll find a way to do it. That was Joseph. He served. And I have here, if we expect to rule, then we must first learn to serve. You will never be over until you first learn to be under. Hallelujah. If you expect to rule, you must expect to serve. You will never be over until you face under. Amen?
Amen.
I know for some of us, we might be under right now. We might be under a cloud of darkness right now. But I stop by to remind you that sunshine is on its way. Hallelujah. I stop here to remind you, hallelujah, that the sun is about to break through your dark cloud. Hallelujah. I stop here to remind you that rain is about to stop. Hallelujah. And the cumulus cloud that has surrounded your life. Hallelujah. The sun is about to take control and light is about to break through over your life. Encourage you. like Joseph, even though you're facing a storm right now, ensure that you have self-control and keep your purity. Hallelujah. I know that the enemy is out there. The Bible says that it's out there. He came to steal, kill, and to destroy. Hallelujah. And even in the midst of your storm, what he's trying to do is allow you to lose self-control and to lose purity. Hallelujah. But I want to encourage you that God came that you might have life this morning. So speak life over every situation you face. Speak life over your body, life over your mind, life over your heart, life over your soul, life over your spirit. Amen. Praise God. And he was with him in suffering. Even when Joseph was forced to endure shame and forced imprisonment, God was with him and God blessed him. God turned Joseph's tragedy into triumph. Hallelujah. I will repeat that. God turned Joseph's tragedy into triumph. This morning, some of you, you're about to experience some triumph. Some of you, you're facing tragedy. That's a tongue twister right there. It's a serious tongue twister. Some of you, you're facing tragedy this morning. But I'm here to remind you that God is about to turn it into triumph. Hallelujah. It might be in your family. It might be in your relationship. Hallelujah. It might be on your job. It might be in your finances. But this morning I stopped by to tell you that your situation is about to turn around. Hallelujah. This morning I stopped by to tell you that your triumph is on its way. Hallelujah. I stopped by to tell you that success is on its way. This morning I stopped by to tell you that that job you've been praying for is on its way. This morning I stopped by to tell you that that healing you've been praying for is on its way. This morning I stopped by to tell you that that family member you've been crying out for salvation, hallelujah, salvation is on its way. Praise God forevermore. What a mighty God we serve this morning. And you know, sometimes it amazes me how God works. Hallelujah. Because it can be dark today and all of a sudden sunshine comes tomorrow. I don't know, man. God is in this business of just turning things around. Praise God. You see, one day for you could be 1,000 years for God. And 1,000 years for you could be 1 hour for God. Praise God. Hallelujah. So I know some of you, you've been crying out for a long time. You've been asking for a long time. You've been losing sleep for a long time. You've been praying for a long time, crying out to God, God, save my son. God, save my family. God, I need a new job. God, I need you to bless me. God, where are you? But this morning I stopped by to remind you that your situation is about to turn around. There is a turnaround that is about to take place in your life, and I believe that it is the season of turnaround. Don't be discouraged, my brothers and my sisters, but be encouraged. Hallelujah. Be encouraged this morning.